There are many SME prevention tools available today than before. Most of them are user initiated. It effectiveness depends upon consistent and correct use or adherence. Aura PrEP is one of the most effective HIV prevention tools we have today, but its main obstacle is adherence. Telling healthy people to take a medicine is complicated enough. Telling them to take a pill every day even more complicated, especially if they perceive that their HIV risk is low. Many young people think HIV is a thing of the past. It won't happen to them. People say that if we make oral PrEP routine, you know, it will help adherence. Unfortunately, it's easier said than done. Many people, just as homeless people, drug users, people who engage in surviving sex, trading sex for basic needs, people in turbulent relationships with or with abusive and exploitative relationships, they don't have normal life. Their life are chaotic, suspenseful, and unpredictable. For them, normal life, routine, privacy, or choice are luxury that they cannot afford. Many young people, especially young adolescents, girls or young women living with parents or with older partner, have little control over their life. For them to take a pill every day can be problematic. It can lead to suspicious distrust and even domestic violence. Adherence is conditioned upon many things. First, people have to have ability to make decisions, and they have to have ability to act and on that actions. And above all, they have to have an enabling environment that supports and sustains that decision and actions. Global oral PrEP uptake among young people remain low, and the rate of oral PrEP discontinuation is quite high. Results from one meta-analysis just published in the Lancet in April this year show that overall 41% of oral PrEP users discontinue in the first 6 months. And for heterosexual oral PrEP users, the discontinuation rate is even high, 22%. There are many reasons why people cannot don't want to take a pill every day. And suboptimal oral PrEP dosing can lead to forcing insecurities and lead to many avoidable and unnecessary HIV infection. Results from two last clinical trials shown that using long-acting cabotegravir given every 2 months as PrEP is safe and effective. It is more effective than oral PrEP because it takes adherence out of equation. Many people will say that long-acting cabotegravir will be expensive. This is true in the beginning. However, history shows that the drug cost will eventually come down substantially if there are competitions and generic drugs. This is a big if, but it can be done, and it has been done many times. So don't let the cost of ARV drug as an excuse to do the right thing. And lesson from oral PrEP showing that people will cycle on and off. That is because HIV release is transient. It waxes and wanes over time as people go through the relationship or transit through different state of their life. So we can expect the same thing as a long-acting cabotegravir PrEP. People who start with long-acting cabotegravir PrEP may switch to oral PrEP later on and vice versa. So providing long-acting cabotegravir PrEP to people won't be a lifelong. For this reason, I want to argue that providing people with long-acting cabotegravir PrEP, people with high risk should be given oral PrEP, long-acting cabotegravir PrEP as the first PrEP option. And the research ethics dictate that if we provide long-acting cabotegravir PrEP to highly skilled people. Participants of a long-acting carbohydrate study should have access as long should have access to long-acting carbohydrate as first option as well. And the principle of fairness and justice stipulate that if we give long-acting carbohydrate to some group of people, anyone with high Asian village should be given the same thing. Otherwise, it would be double standard. So let's do this one. Don't let this window of opportunity pass away. It will be unfortunate, irresponsible. Thank you very much for listening.